Want a truly useful scheduler for all your social media? This tool is free, and I'm going to walk you through how it works, what the limitations of the free program is, and how you can use it getting started today. This is Metricool, and I'm going to walk you through the benefits and the drawbacks of the free plan, and then I'm going to make another video about the paid one. Let's start with the free one. This has got heaps of features that a lot of free tools don't have. For example, you can automatically schedule to Instagram, which often is a paid feature in many processes, and the sheer breadth of the different accounts that you can connect with are huge. I've connected to Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. I can't connect to LinkedIn in the free plan, and I can connect to Pinterest and to TikTok and to Google My Business, YouTube, Twitch, which I don't have, Facebook ads, Google ads, and TikTok ads if I was running them. It also attaches to my website, and I only just set this up, and it's only reporting the things that are coming out in terms of where the location of traffic's coming. But what it's doing is it's starting to record where people are coming from and what they're going and having a look at in terms of my blogs. And it also will show where they've what they've linked on in terms of whether they've come from Pinterest or other things. So I'm seeing the actual effects of how effective my marketing is on my website traffic, which is huge. And having this all together in one spot is really great. The only drawbacks around the free plan really is for me, in terms of the things I can add in, is that I have a Facebook group that I'd like to put on too. I need to use premium to do that. I can't use LinkedIn, which is one of my core platforms, unless I become premium. So that obviously is a big frustration for me too. However, there are some huge assets to the free plan that you can't do on many other things. So for example, if Instagram is one of your core plans, you can actually schedule stories and reels in Instagram. Metricool also helps you work out and look at all your demographics across the way. So what I like about this is it does give a really good clear breakdown of your different demographics across the different groups and pulls that information in. So it gives you a really great visibility across your brand. Some of the things I haven't done yet is you can actually also track competitors. You can do, I think it's up to five on the free one. And then if you've got a professional one, you can do up to 100. So you can be tracking your content and having a look at things. It also will show you your posts and feed through your posts and show you what your engagement levels are and all those other bits and pieces, which I really like to be able to follow and look at. So let's just go and have a look at how you would create it. Oh, so that's the backwards. There's also a real time part where it's actually showing you what people are doing on real time, in particular around your website. So it's tracking your website. It also has an opportunity for you to be able to use this for your messaging. So any messaging that comes through, it will sync through into here as well. And it has your Twitter as well. I don't use Twitter a lot, but it does have my published tweets here. You can see I don't really do a lot here. I've got a best friend. That's nice, isn't it? All right, so that's how you would use this here. I think that ability to track, it also allows you to do hashtag tracking as well if you want to. That is a paid part of it. So again, it's a restriction. So you can't necessarily do that, but there is just that option. If you are using a particular hashtag for an event or wanting to follow something to particularly comment on it and follow it, you'd be able to do that using these hashtags. But that's a paid part. We're only focusing on the free parts. So let's dive into how you would use this for your social media. So when it comes to planning your content, one of the things I really like about it is it shows you really clearly the best time to put to post. And what it does is it says that the deeper the pink is, the better time it is to post, and the lighter it is, the worst time. And it does the same with Facebook as well, but it does it with blue. So you can see here that it's pretty much saying that this is the best time along here for me to post on Facebook. And when I go and have a look on Instagram, let's click that, it's the pink. It has definitely that this is the time between 9 and 10, except for weirdly, on a Thursday, it's a little bit later. And then it has these other parts, but then the deep part is between that 7 to 9 here. So that for me, that would be what mine would be like. Then if I want to go and create a post, all I need to do is create one in here. Now, does the free plan only has 50 posts available? I'm going to rip through that really fast, which is why I'm going to need to have the free plan, the paid plan. However, if you've only got a couple of platforms or you're wanting to use it just specifically for one or two different platforms, then this would be a really good thing to use, just a freebie or just to try and see how it works. In terms of Instagram too, it does also preview your feed so you can have a wee look and see how it's going to look. So these are actually with my scheduled posts, so I'm actually able to see what they look like a little bit like later does. So I can actually see how it's going to look on my feed, which is also kind of cool. All right, so we're going to create a new post in here, and when it comes up, you basically just click on the ones that you want to have. So I'm going to choose Instagram. I'm not going to post this to any other ones at the moment, but I could if I wanted to. If it fitted, I could do that one and Google My Business if I wanted to. And so I'm just going to come in here and I'm just going to do like a little test version in here. So I'm just going to add an image from computer and just grab one in here. So I'm just going to select it. I'm just going to pull up one of these ones. I'll pull up this one. Okay, so I've got my cute little Spud House Publishing, which is our new publishing house logo. And then I'm going to put test in here in terms of, I'll probably spell it right. At least I'm going to do test a bit and to spell it right. And then I can copy and paste my hashtags in here. So I'm just going to go copy and paste hashtags. I use hashtag Slayer for this. So I would just go and grab them and put them in there. So I can do that. I can search for hashtags if I want. I can add a location. So I could add Auckland in here. And it will come up. It normally comes up somewhere. I might have to do it again. Auckland. Here we go, Auckland, New Zealand. So I can put my hashtags in there. I can put any emojis. I can even add a GIF if I want to. It can upload video. I haven't tried it with carousel posts, so there's just that to be aware of. And so I just need to keep an eye on all those bits and pieces. And then what I can do is I'm going to put this in advance so that I don't accidentally post this today. I can go, okay, I want it on the 2nd of March and I want to have it in that late period of time. So I'm going to go 7:39 p.m. And then I can press save like this and it will create that post. And then what I can do, so I'm just going to go and find it here, so it's here, is I can press plus and I can duplicate it. So I can go duplicate. And then I've got another one here that I can do, which has got the same content in it. I'm going to get rid of the hashtags on the duplicated one. I'm going to change it to Facebook and I'm going to change the time, but I've kept everything the same. And so I might do that one on the Thursday at the 7 p.m. and then I'm going to press save like that. And then I'm going to go and duplicate that one for Twitter or whatever, and maybe change some of the words so it's shorter. And it makes it super, super easy to put that same post across all the different platforms without it being complicated. Now, of course, what I could do is do a whole lot of these at the same time, but then I have to be conscious of the limits of time. In terms of Pinterest, when you do your Pinterest ones, it will show you what board you need to do. So you need to come down here and say what the title is going to be for your SEO reach for that. And then the board here in terms of what you're going to share. When it comes to Instagram, you can see it can choose you a feed post, a reel, or a story. So these are both manual postings. You still have to post them manually, but you can put them into here and then you'll get a reminder to post them. So you can plan those things ahead. For reels, for me, I think this is great because I struggle to type away on my little phone to type everything out. If I can put them in here and load them up in here, that's going to make it much easier for me. I can still manually hit post and post them on my phone, but it's going to feed through, which is great. And then also on here, you have the same. I'm going to take this one off. This one just is for the feed. There's no reels function there. On TikTok, I can add videos on here as well. So I can create those videos. I'm just going to get rid of that and that. So I can create some videos here. And as you can see here, it will show you up here how this works in terms of the publishing. So it'll say that it's posted and then it'll go into my inbox ready for me to post. So it basically means I can run more of my things on my desktop from those areas. And I'm also monitoring and sharing the information in here too, which I think is great. So Metricool is a great place to come and use if you're really struggling with trying to put things in the same place. There is this free option here. What I think is great is you could just use it for a couple of different core platforms that you're using. I'm just going to obviously just get rid of this post here. So I'll just show you how easily you can do that too. So we just want to cancel that. Oh, sorry. Delete down here, so you can just hit delete. So I'll get rid of that post there, and I'll do the same on the other one that I did it wherever I did it. But you can just it's just so easy to use. You can preview the feeds, you can export everything, and if you want to, you can also, if you've got repetitive posts you want to do, you can put them in a spreadsheet and import them in here and have them go through in a cycle too. So it just makes it really possible. There's one other thing I want to show you on here, which is super. So if you want to use a link in bio with your Instagram, I haven't set this up yet, but you can come in here and create your like a little landing page bio and put that in there. And then what will happen is you can use that for your Instagram and also for your TikTok as well and for Twitter. And I think that's pretty cool as well. That's Metricool. That's the free program, and I will do another video about the premium once I've upgraded and show you the